It's always nice to be part of a festival where people come to appreciate good films. I think that's basically it. You know, it's a discerning audience. A director and writer would describe it as an urban ghost story. So it doesn't necessarily fit into what might typify the horror genre. Although it's a scary film, but it's also rooted in naturalism and realism.
Is that what appealed to you about the project, that kind of grounding and kind of naturalism?
It's part of it, definitely, but the script is very, very tight. It's a really tight story, and I think it's a very moving story, and that's something that, for me, makes it work better. I think when there are certain kind of horror movie makers that just go for one thing, which is to frighten people, but actually I think the psychological kind of story underneath that underlies those things is much more interesting. You know, obvious films like The Shining or whatever, you know, they're moving as well as scary. Yeah, it was one of those things. It was just a lovely bunch of people, talented, interesting, clever, and nice, and I think what Ollie was brilliant at doing was getting it's kind of a relationship based film more than anything else in a lot of ways, father son and father daughter, and that was what we worked on the hardest, was getting to that point where we looked like a father and son, or a father and daughter over here. It was all about, it's a relationship based film, it's character based, so as opposed to plot based.
And what are you moving on to next? Have you got anything else in works at the moment?
I've got a thing coming out called The Driver, which is a TV series, three-part series, David Morrissey, which I'm very excited about.